Hello, hello everybody, and welcome to another World of Tanks video. Today we're taking a look at a replay of myself, and I'm playing in the Leeuwen. I'm playing in a platoon together with Korsakov, who's playing in his Jagdpanzer too. And we are on Fiery Assailant with a 40% match, tier 9. And yeah, I really don't like this map very much. And I'll get into it as soon as I get the chance to, but first let me talk about my starting position. Now, along the railroad, about the F6 area, is generally where I like to go with my heavy tanks in this map. Unless there's artillery on the enemy team. Because if artillery is on the enemy team, they generally take a shit on you. And they completely annihilate your tank. There's just nowhere for you to hide, and yeah, GW Tiger P will do a metric butt-ton of damage to me there. Basically, he has to click 3 times and I'm dead. I know this will happen, but somebody needs to go there. Somebody, especially on this side, needs to go there, because on the hill, right around the... I'll make the map slightly bigger for you, hold on. There we go. Right around the F0 area, on that slope, is generally where a lot of tanks camp. And if nobody's on the mid ridge, about F6, then yeah, there's nobody taking shots at the flanks of those, and they can just get there uncontested and stay there. So nobody goes towards the mid, so I have to. And I'm just praying and praying that this GW Tiger pig doesn't destroy me. GW Tiger P is it officially, of course, but yeah. For those of you who watch Quickie Baby a lot will know that the P actually stands for pig. It's quite understandable. Anyway. First person gets spotted on the hill, it's Lorraine. In the Leeuwen gets spotted, my counterpart gets spotted camping right at the back. There's a fair few tanks on the left flank, and as you can see there's a fair few tanks right in front of me as well. And the game starts off not too great. I get shot by an Oni, and the D-34 is laying in wait too. And that shot was an AP shell of the GW Tiger P, which is of course something I'm not very happy about. Now luckily I'm in a platoon, and Korsakov in his Jagdpanzer 2 is going to support me from the hill, whilst I try desperately to be as confusing as possible to the artillery. Tiger gets spotted in the middle, not really sure what he's doing there, he's not being particularly useful for his team, but yeah, perhaps he thinks he's a medium tank, or a light tank. More of a light tank really, the mid-range scouting, but medium tanks can definitely do it. Heavy tank number 6 gets spotted, no idea where that shell went. To me it looked like it flew straight into his turret, but for some reason it didn't. Aiming, aiming. I'm going to take a blind shot here. T-34 gets spotted, who is also pointing his gun towards the hill. And this is also a reason why I should be in mid. Although, if I wouldn't be here, these tanks would first of all not be spotted, and second of all, there'd be nobody putting pressure on their front. So they could just shoot at the hill uncontested, which is definitely not what you want. And another artillery shell lands behind me. And yet again, this is very lucky. This GW Tiger P is probably not aiming very well. Now I'm going to try and take some shots at the hill. But not before I check this T-34, who gets taken out by Korsakov. So that's one very nice thing. And as soon as I can, I need to start taking shots at the hill, because that tier 9 heavy tank, the VK4502B, is a very, very heavily armored tank, and I should definitely try and take it out if I can. There it is. There we go. Now Korsakov will be taking shots at that VK as well. Unfortunately, it's so heavily armored that even when the tank is pointing upwards towards, he's on an incline, the lower plate is extra flat to Korsakov, he can't pan it with gold. That tank is just so brutally heavily armored frontally that even its lower plate is too strong for gold to penetrate with a tank destroyer. So yeah, that gives you an idea of what kind of how important it is that I take as many side shots on this tank as I can. I'm definitely prioritizing it here, and I'm definitely taking a risk as well. There's a very high likelihood, there we go, that I could get shot at a couple of times. But this is just a risk I'll have to take. If I can take out that VK, the rest of our team can advance there a little bit further and be just a little bit safer. And given the amount of tanks that are currently there, it's kind of important that that guy dies. And there he, there he actually does die. Oni is still sitting there, but now that Korsakov, the KV-13 and all the other tanks at the hill no longer have anything to shoot at in front of them, they'll actually be shooting at this Oni. So I'm going to try and keep him spotted. That's my next job, so to say. I see the Oni, aim for his cupola. Flies through, does damage. Very nice indeed. It's a nice accurate gun of the Leeuwen, but I must say that was a bit of a lucky hit. There's still more tanks there as well. There's a Tiger 1, there we go. Who's currently making his way up the hill. Unfortunately just outside of render distance for Korsakov, so we can't take a shot. But for now we're actually in quite a dominant position. When the middle here falls, I can actually help with mid. And luckily artillery takes a shit on this Oni, which is precisely why I generally don't like going towards mid. There we go, nice hit. Leave him on 50 hit points. Which is of course very nice. Meanwhile the left flank appears to be more or less won. There's still a Heimetal Bolsuk unspotted and a Jagdtiger. Not sure where they are. My guess at the time was that they were about at B6, camping at the back. Now the reason I'm taking blindshot is Korsakov is telling me that he's actually getting spotted. I'm expecting these medium tanks to be in bushes up at the top so they can't really get spotted. So I take a shot at a few of the possible bushes they might sit in the hope that I might hit a few blind shots. We'll see in post-game stats if I hit any of them. So far I've actually shot at one T69. It might be that I've hit a few blind shots, we'll see. Can't quite see the Tiger here. There I do, but for some reason the shell flies wide and I can't actually hit him. Find the Jagdtiger. And I see the T69. I bounce off the top of the turret. Probably hit the roof of the turret at an extreme angle. Not a real large chance of hitting that. There's a Rheinmetall Bolzik, and here I decide to push on. I now know where all the enemy tanks are. So I should probably make my way down. So I can take out first of all the Tiger P, of course. GW Tiger P. Lucky shot that that hit, but yeah. Might just have saved him. Not really, the Conqueror I was going to say, but he gets taken out by what I would think is the T69, maybe? What took him out? Let's see. Charioteer. Oh, our own team destroyed him. Ah, there we go. There's actually a team killer on our team. I'm not sure how he could possibly hit him. But we'll see in the postgame stats if he was actually trolling, yes or no. Now I'm going to try and get my way towards the back as quickly as I can. I actually tell the team that look, I'm going to make my way around. You'll have some flanking shots. So I move as quickly as I can, which is not very fast in this tank, as I mentioned in earlier videos on the Leeuwen. But I'm almost there. There's still a medium tank there. Not sure on what kind of health he is. And now I spot the Jagdtiger. And I'm hoping to get an engine shot here. Consider shooting at his tracks, but unfortunately didn't really work out. And here I think I can take just one more shot, unfortunately. I can, but... yeah, this was a bit of a sketchy shot. I'm not really sure if I should have taken that shot, to be honest. And here I go out again, and this is just stupid. I decide to repair my my tracks because the T69 has an autoloader. No idea how many shots he's fired, so it might just be that he would be able to punish me over and over and over again. And unfortunately, my engine is quite broken at this point. Consider capping, but I see that the team is pushing on, and I feel like our best chances of winning is actually taking out the enemies. So together with my broken engine, I gallop up this hill at a staggering 5 km/h. Now the incline increases slightly more, so I decrease in speed to a staggering 4 km/h. And yeah, it's not really going fast for me, is it? The Conqueror is still complaining in the chat that the charioteer on our team killed him. I'm not really sure what happened. So I'm not going to... I didn't actually report him afterwards either. I'm not sure what he did. I didn't really see what happened very well. So, can't really do anything there. But I can definitely understand the Conqueror being pissed. Well, that was the last kill. Let's take a look at the post-game stats. Now, as we can see, In the post-game stats, I actually hit both the T69s and I only damaged one that I can see. So I definitely hit a blind shot as well, which is of course nice to see. So one of these, this 240 damage, because I definitely don't remember seeing a low roll that low when I was actually playing. So a 240 damage was one I hit blind. Now, on top of all the damage I did, we can also see that this was a WN8 of slightly short of 6,500, which is considerably less than the ace tanker you saw from me before, or considerably more than the ace tanker you saw from me before. So this was also definitely an ace tanker match. Now, I wasn't very excited about going towards the middle at first, because I was definitely afraid of this GW Tiger B, who actually still had a rather decent game, all things considered. So I don't know what he was shooting at, but he missed me twice, and I'm very happy about this, because this is the only reason I was able to have as big of an impact as I actually had. Now, we see our artillery actually did well as well. Definitely saw him taken out at ONI. Probably did more, because 3,500 damage is quite a lot. Or 3.1 damage, 3,100. Let's try that again, shall we? 3,100 damage. There we go. I can speak. Now we can see Korsakov actually also had a very nice game. He did actually get taken out at one point there, but yeah, I definitely carried his weight. This 2,600 damage, he actually, or 2,700 almost, he said was mostly towards targets that I was spotting for him. So whilst I was busy taking out tanks on the hill, so that would be this, where's the VK? There we go, he barely did anything. I was able to do so much damage to him before he was ever able to do anything for his team. So that was an important kill. And the T69s were also not able to have the impact they needed. I was able to, each time they got spotted, I was able to take shots at them, which meant that, well, they really couldn't do much. And it left our tanks, for instance, the Conqueror, the Yak, Korsakov of course, and myself to do a lot of damage. In the detailed report, we can see I fired 19 shots, of which a few blind shots as well. So 14 hits was very nice indeed. Two of them didn't penetrate, so probably I actually bounced another shot at of the blind shot, so to say. Not really sure about that though. I can remember one bounce on the medium tank earlier, but I can't really remember any other. So I think that's actually a blind shot that bounced as well. Anyway, did 3,370 damage, which is of course nice, of which 1,284 were further away than 300 meters. I received a grand total of 1,344 damage, and I also managed to block a little with my armor, which somehow means that I have less potential damage than the amount of damage I received. Something is weird in these stats here. Anyway, was also able to do almost 3,556 spotting damage, which is of course all those tanks in the middle, and maybe even a few on the hillside as well, that I spotted, and that artillery and my friends on the hill were able to do damage against. So this was definitely something nice as well. Now, was also a nice moneymaker this match. Didn't fire any premium ammunition, so 67,848 silver is always very nice, especially considering I don't use a premium account. And luckily for me as well, this was 1,337 experience. Now, you don't actually see it here, but I also had a, what they're called, the personal reserves on, so I got 50% extra experience, meaning I got 2,140 experience from this match, which is more or less what I would have gotten if I were playing in a premium tank. So I'm quite happy about this. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video as well. It goes to show that sometimes being the guy that goes to the position somebody needs to go to, but they usually die, which was in this case my myself, you can actually sometimes do really well if you get lucky. Because make no mistake, if this GW Tiger P would have taken me out first, I would definitely have had a bad game. Three full reloads, he missed twice, which I got lucky with, so yeah. But anyway, I did what I had to. Somebody had to go there, and I did, and this time it actually worked out really, really well, and I got a very, very nice game indeed. I hope you enjoyed watching it. If you did, please leave a like, and I'll see you for the next one.